But in my search, I found a very interesting YouTube video.
Woke up this morning, turned on my TV set. There in living color was something I can't forget. This man was preaching at me, yeah, laying on a charm, asking me for 20 with 10,000 on his arm. He wore designer clothing and a big smile on his face, selling me salvation while they sang Amazing Grace. Asking me for money when he had all the signs of wealth. Almost wrote a check out, yeah, then I asked myself, would he wear a pinky ring? Would he drive a fancy car? Would his wife wear furs and diamonds? Would his dressing room have a star? If he came back tomorrow, there's something I'd like to know.
Can you tell me?
Would Jesus wear a gold ring on his television show? Would Jesus be political if he came back to earth? Have his second home in Palm Springs, yeah, but try to hide his worth. Take money from those poor folks when he comes back again, and admit he's talked to all those preachers who say they've been a-talking to him. Lord help us. Just ask yourself, would he wear a pinky ring? Would he drive a fancy car? Would his wife wear furs and diamonds? Would his dressing room have a star? If he came back to battle, that's something I'd like to know. Could you tell me, would Jesus wear a Rolex? Would Jesus wear a Rolex? Would Jesus wear a Rolex on his television show?
Brother.
So what do you think? You think he'd wear a Rolex on his television show? What have they done? They've taken the truths here and perverted it, just like Satan loves to do. They took the truth that we are to give in devotion to God. We're to give of ourselves. But it becomes more about us and me and my pinky rings. Not a real good idea. The question I'm asking you this morning is, whom do you serve and what is the proof? Most likely, no one in this room is either Mary or Judas. We fall somewhere in the center. But are you happy where you are in your devotion to Christ? Can you, through His grace, serve Him better? I say yes. I know I can. I know I fall way short on my devotion to Him. But you know what? It's not real hard to do. We just follow what He says. We treasure our relationship with Christ. And guess what? When we treasure His Word and treasure Him, our heart will follow behind it. Our heart will grow there. And we must be on continual guard and making Him the number one thing above all other things in our life. It is so easy for things to sneak in, but I have a sinking feeling that if we follow number one and treasuring Him, we're not going to have a real hard time with number two. And finally, we must recognize we can't do it on our own. It is only by His grace can we follow Him better. So let us ask Him, God, give me the grace. Give me the ability. It's not about me pumping something up in me. It's about Christ and God giving it to me. And let us be willing vessels in that. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank You, God, for Your Word. We thank You for Your truth. I pray, dear Lord, that You just help our hearts be right before You. Help my heart be right before You. Let us treasure You above all things. And let our hearts follow after that. We thank You for Your truth. We thank You for Your Word. We thank You for the examples that You've laid out before us. I pray all these things in Jesus Christ's holy name. Amen.